This is a whole series on why recovery coaching. I thought I should include an about me section. I've spoken and given a lot of my thoughts, my stories, my work with other clients, my perspectives on pretty much everything to do with recovery or addictions or alcoholism, and there will be more yet. There's a lot to dig into, and I have 23 years in the industry, in the business professionally, not as a side goer, but literally in the business professionally. That's all I've been doing for 23 years. And prior to then, I've got, say, 30 or 40 years in health and wellness. So I've been around and very comfortable in the field and in the industry. Here's a little bit about me that I have not shared commonly with a video audience. Like most young men, I grew up in this case in an, I think it could be qualified as an inner city. It was the West End of Vancouver. At the time, it was a higher density area, but it was mostly immigrants and or immigrant families, some individuals who, like myself, are born Canadian, born as a Canadian, who had immigrant parents, some not. So very, very comfortable in a multicultural community. His best friend, I think, was from Africa, or had African parents. He had no accent, so I suspect he may have been born in Canada. Never got into that. Never came up. It wasn't a big issue, and many of my other friends, again, there was a Canadian family, but most were immigrants. So again, multicultural situation. And while growing up, as one can expect, drinking in the order that they were presented to me, drinking through the family, had my first drink of significance. In other words, I got drunk or bombed or loaded or call it what you like at 11. Could have been, was it earlier? Was 10 and a half or 11. Let's call it 11 for now, just to be on the comfortable side. So at 11. And my father got me on my first, I didn't get a hangover, but I definitely got drunk. And it was a party. I was young. I showed up at the party in my PJs. There were absolutely beautiful women at the party, and they could have nothing. They had nothing better to do than talk and chat up a nice, cute little young 11-year-old, having his first couple of drinks in his PJs, right? And, got my first, kiss from a not a stranger, but from a beautiful lady, actually several, beautiful Caucasian lady, beautiful black lady. I was doing great, okay? This was my first experience with alcohol drinking, let's say getting drunk. And it was a pretty good one, I thought. Even got some hot tips. Put your foot on the floor when the bed starts spinning and your head starts spinning. Okay, I had to use that one that particular night. So you can judge how much I drank or didn't drink. Again, my provider was my father, and curious little conversation that was going on as he was, mixing these various drinks for me, whether it was I think I was having a rum and coke, and I could have had gin and seven or something. And there was seven up. There was a couple of things I drank, but I was drinking hard like mixed hard liquor drinks. Okay, that was my first experience. It had all the earmarkers of, an early beginning. Or let's call it an early start to drinking in excess. There was nothing apparently negative about it. And yet, one of my father's friends was actually chastising my father for doing what he was doing. And my father took it in stride. I was watching the conversation as, this friend of my father was basically just berating my father for, feeding a, young kid alcohol and getting him drunk. And my father's response is, he's going to do it anyway, better at home, with family, people who love him. Again, there's another seed to, and another clue to how I got involved in drinking way too much. Did I become alcoholic? I don't think so. Did I drink to excess and need to make a major change? Like qu I quit many, many times throughout my career of being abstinent, reduced drinking, moderate drinking, and now no drinking at all for 15 years, 16 years, I think. So there was all kinds of various pieces to that story as it unfolded into my future. But that's where it started. And it had, again, all the earmarks for a problem in the future. I'll cover some of the general ones. Love, family, alcohol. All there, all present, okay? Some of you may not have discovered this. If it's a new discovery for you, wonderful. The connection between various levels of hypnotic command and or suggestive inference or suggestive command and drinking increases, so the efficacy or effectiveness of these suggestions or in some cases, straight up hypnotic commands increase to the degree that an individual is drinking or blacks out. Okay, it goes into whatever you want to call it, unconscious, subconscious mind, all conscious, whatever. It goes into the body, and the body is recording it. Mind body records that and the suggestion. And I was being told, yes, as long as there's people around who love him, it's better than drinking with strangers, and he's going to do it anyway. Okay, listen to those commands or suggestions. So, and I followed those suggestions just like a wound-up doll. And by 18, 19, 20, playing rugby, and anyone who's been in the industry of rugby knows what goes on in rugby practices, games, parties, and the degree of involvement of drinking and drinking in excess has to rugby. It's pretty significant. Well, I played that role out quite well. Okay. And I was with people who loved me. They were my buddies, they were my teammates, So, a little piece of the story as it unfolded, and there are more pieces to it. I think I'll leave it at that, because specifically I wanted to speak on alcohol, how I got started, and some of the factors that I had to unpack as I started to ask myself, why would a person, me, who was completely health conscious, completely focused on health since 16, just a health, not a guru, not a junkie, but just very focused on being as healthy as I could. I was always a very, very good athlete, and focused on improving my athleticism and my conditioning. Not so much, actually, I wasn't interested, and still I'm not interested at all in any level of bodybuilding or physique. I'm completely interested in my ability and my competency in a particular sport and my ease of playing a particular sport and doing it. That is my high, if you will, being able easily and competently and comfortably engage in the sport of my choice. That's when I feel my best. Why would a guy like that be interested in numbing their abilities out, removing and stepping themselves down from health? Alcohol is not a healthy substance at all, period. And then have that lead to other drugs and injuries and so on. All stuff we can unpack in recovery coaching. It's an incredibly interesting area. I've got my own story. You have yours, but more importantly, you have your story that not only can be unpacked, but can be used for your recovery, not for your continued drinking or drug abuse. There's actually value to your story, especially when heard from another who understands and has gone through that piece of recovery and professionally takes others through it. Look forward to your conversation. My name's Anthony, recovery coach, and a little bit about